Hei Norge, hello Eurovision fans, and hello to all singers, songwriters, producers who are watching this video as well, maybe, maybe not. It's time for Melodi Grand Prix semi-final 3, my favorite pre-selection. It's Norway, I really love it, and I can't wait to be in Trondheim, so I will go to Trondheim watching the live show with Eurovision fans, German Eurovision fans, and friends, so I'm not alone there. I can't wait to be there, I was there last year, and now again. I'm looking so much forward, so if you see me there, say hello, let's have a drink, let's have a conversation. And now to the video, I will do a lot of reaction videos, not just to Norway, of course to the other countries as well, so don't forget to subscribe my channel. And now to the semi-final 3, you'll see a long video, hopefully with timestamps, if they work out, you can jump to the reaction video you like to listen to, or better, you watch the whole video. In the end of the video, I'll send my personal top 3, which songs I would love to see in the final, which songs I think will go to the final based on the audio, and what I guess the live performance might look like. And you can write down your thoughts under the video, what you love or not. And now it's time for semi-final 3, and I would say, let's get into it. Okay, taking again a deep breath, because it's starting with KEiiNO, oh my god. I have high expectations, I hope not too high. And let's start. Okay. Give me life. Getting some dancey vibes now. Maybe part usual fans will sing along. Okay, it's all ready for the youth club. They are already ready to play the song. Okay, I was not expecting a song like this one. I love her voice so much from Alex. So after Split in the Sky and Monument. Of course, I know the songs, we know the songs a bit longer than this song, it's my first listen now. I'm not quite sure here right now. I like the vibe, I like, can dance to it. I guess we're getting the joking. Oh yeah, she will nail that life, she will nail that life, 100%. Okay, Toms. I'm not sure, personally. Maybe I have too high expectations, but I think it's not in this case. I have to compare, I'm so sorry. Split in the Sky was there, Monument was there, and the song's not as strong as these two songs. We have to wait for live performance. Because I know Alex will bring it up live. He said that he's just singing the title the whole time. That's it. So that was not really joking there. I'm a bit disappointed. I don't know if they can win Melodi Grand Prix. Especially the jury won't like it. So I think it's not a straight winner here right now. Sorry, KEiiNO. So the next song. Turn around, heading down memory lane. We have Miia now. It's always the same with us. She has a very beautiful voice. I love her voice. Where do we go? Are we losing our drive? From what I can listen, I would say I can judge that she can bring it up live as well. Oh, the beat. I like it. I love the production here. Okay, the pre-bridge. Is it? Can you call it pre-bridge? Or is it a bridge already? I really enjoy her voice. I would love to see Miia again at Melodi Grand Prix in case she won't win. She's brilliant. She's really brilliant. I have a feeling we might produce the song here right now. Just a feeling. And that's it. Oh. I'm so sorry I didn't say much to Greenlight. I like the production, I love her voice, I like the song. I need a live performance here. The first listen is, sometimes you have songs, you listen to and you need a second listen, and this was the song. And now, Annprincess, I love her name, by the way. I love the attitude in the song, buddy. She has attitude. I can hear that. Sounds very Melodi Festival. Again, like kind of feeling to produce a song. Like this with the sound. This is a song you would love. I love this part. Oh, I love this part. I can see it's saying kind of the Melodi Festival, kind of staging here. I would love to see us in final. I don't know if she can win Melodi Grand Prix. I love this part so much. Production at some point. I enjoy it. I think this might be a song people will love. A lot of Eurovision fans. Yes. The next song. Yeah, the next song is Thomas Jenssen. Oh, the singer is Thomas Jenssen. Take Me to Heaven. He has attitude as well. I like that vibe. From the audio, I don't know. I hope he can pull that out completely live. And that it won't get flat. I enjoy that. And I think he bring. I saw the artist announcement, and he sprung up like such a nice attitude. I think he has a lot of stage presence, which could help him. It's not strong from the audio personally, but this song is more for the live performance. So this might get him to the final. Especially when there's no jury, that's just televoting. But for me, it's not the strongest song in the selection here right now. But this could maybe surprise in the live show. Oh. I didn't see this version coming. This was good. I hope we can... These high notes. Thomas, I hope you can sing them live. Don't disappoint me. It's getting much, much better here right now. I think a lot of people will love the song. That could be enough to go to the final. That people love this tune. Yeah, I like it. The next song is by Mistra. So we're getting a white song again. I think. A bit creepy. But it has my attention. It's always good. It's like, what will happen? Oh, yes. No, I'm getting it. This could be a moment on stage. So much I want to thank you for. Will you walk me through that door? I need to leave love. It's like holding back and then whoosh. Stage-wise, you can do a lot of that. I can see this going to the finals. Oh, you can so do so much. Oh, please don't disappoint me with the live performance and live staging. I think the song will explode again now. I'm alive and life is of course, holding back first. I'm coming with you willingly. Time's moving fast and I lose my breath in this wonderful waltz of death. Ah, okay, it's going already to the end. I enjoyed it. This could be something. The next song, the last song, is by Vidar Villa. Yeah. Like that good vibe. The vibe here. I love that we have a song like this in a Bruce selection, like Good Vibe song in Norwegian. I'm quite sure a lot of people liking the song. For me, it's not because of the language, it's just. Don't get me 100%. Even though the vibe I get, but not the whole song. It's enjoyable, it's cute. It's a very easy melody, but it's so easy to come in. and I can see like Norwegian people singing along and getting the vibe. Like, so this could help actually. Maybe this can go to the final. For me personally not, but it could maybe surprise, maybe. I don't know how Norwegian feel this song. And it's over. It's over. So this was the last song of semi-final 3. This means this was the last song of all 18 songs. And now my thoughts about all 6 songs from semi-final 3. So we had 6 songs from semi-final 3. And I have to say this mix was nice. I was a bit disappointed. Of course, KEiiNO, you were like, oh, it's KEiiNO and it will win the whole competition. It could happen. But for me personally, I think they're going to the final. I think it is in my top 3. Yeah, it's my top 3 personally. But I'm not sure if they can win or will win. In the final, we have a jury. And even if Split in the Sky, the jury was taking them. And it's not a jury song. And it could be like an effect like, I don't think it will happen or something like Statements, Lorraine thing, it won't go to the final. But it doesn't scream Melodi Grand Prix winner. And I was expecting a different song from them. And I think many Eurovision fans might be disappointed. Of course, many people may be loving this song, I'm quite sure. For me, it's good. I'm rating the live performance and then I can judge a bit more, but it's not for me the winner personally from all 18 songs. It will go to the final. I like it from this semi-final 3 selection. Also, I love the third song. I have to look up. Annprincess. I think Annprincess should go to the final from the audio. I really enjoyed it. I hope she can bring it up live. The same with Mistra, this is like more a live performance song. It had my attention the whole time. I really enjoyed it. To the other songs we had, we have the second song here, Miia. I enjoyed Miia as well, great voice, but I couldn't judge it from the first listen. I think this might go to my top 3 with Annprincess, Mistra, and yeah, the last song, Villa. The name was Vidar Villa and Thomas Jenssen. They can surprise actually live and going to the final. It's most likely not happen, but I wouldn't be shocked. So we have to wait again for live performance. So personally, KEiiNO, Miia, Annprincess, Mistra, these 4. I can't take 3 here right now. And going to the final, KEiiNO, quite sure, and then it will be difficult. Mistra could pop out a lot live, but here, it's difficult. I will wait for live performances, and then, now, of course, then we know the 3 finals, but I watch all the, I will watch all the semi-final live shows, and then I can judge it a bit more. So not just the 3 finalists, of course I would say like if I love the 4th, 5th and 6th place in the semi-final. But here, there's no song screaming for Melodi Grand Prix winner. But we will rate the live performance. So what do you think now? I will ask you. What do you think about semi-final 3? Do you think KEiiNO can win Melodi Grand Prix? Do you love the song? Are you disappointed like me a bit? Or not? Who do you think will go to the final? Write a comment under the video. So what's your opinion? Do you like my video? Then of course thumb up. And don't forget I will do more reaction videos, not just to Norway. Of course there will be more reaction videos to Norway. We have other countries. So don't forget to subscribe my channel. To all 6 semi-finalists, a heart from Germany. I wish you all the best. Have much fun on stage in Oslo. Maybe going to Trondheim. Maybe we will meet each other. Who knows? I will be there. Can't wait. So, enjoy it. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video. Bye-bye.